In today's video, I will show you how to create light leak effect and transition at $0 using the cookware available in your kitchen. You've heard it right, the cookware available in your kitchen. You need doing it in the dark to have more control on the light. I've been testing this for a long time, and the conclusion is each material produces different look and effect. You can use any shiny and reflective material. For this video, I'm going to use coffee Chemex, a glass of water, and a stainless steel saucepan. Every item should be reflective and shiny, otherwise it's not gonna work. Definitely need a camera and a zoom lens with wide aperture, such f1.4, 1.8, or even 2.8. Shallow depth of field is what you should be looking for. I tried my 70-200 f4 at 200mm and it worked, while at 70 f4 doesn't give the effect we want. And to start, you need the following: a blackboard or any other non-reflective black material. You can also use a reflector black backside, like this. There's no room for it in the camera, alright? But you get the idea. Alright, so here we go. You also need a clamp holder. Masking tape is an option as well. A light stand to hold the blackboard, or simply you can fix it on the wall instead. However, you absolutely need a camera tripod. A small LED light or any other source of light does the job. Even your smartphone torchlight. I will be linking all these accessories down below, so make sure to check them. Alright, it doesn't matter what camera you're using, but make sure switching to manual mode. Aperture to the widest, my 85mm lens, for example, has 1.8 maximum aperture. Adjust your exposure and ISO until you see a completely black background. Set focus to manual and focus to infinity. And make sure your white balance is roughly 5000 Kelvin. To end up with warm colors. And the cool part starts here. Alright, and before I start recording, make a couple tests. It's not easy to master it from the first time, so set the camera on a tripod and the light position, rotation angle, and the movement speed are only what you have to control. To make light leak transitions like this, have to make fast movements close to the camera. Make sure to fill the frame once, to avoid the jump cuts, you know. Hit it again, start from the outside, and move in quickly, then out. Boom! These are some transitions and light leak effects I came up with. Feel free to download them, we'll keep links in the description box down below. And to make a dreamy light look effect like this, you have to make a smooth, slow movement. You're probably not gonna nail it from the first time, just practice it. I do my video work on Adobe Premiere. However, if you are using a different video editing software, just get the general idea how to apply the light leak effect on your footage. Okay, so create a new sequence and absolutely add your footage and the light leak video on the upper layer. And in the effect control panel, change the blending mode from normal to screen. The footage I'm giving you are in 4K, so scale it down to 50% if you are working in 1080 sequence. Switch to color layout, or simply hit the Lumetri color correction effect. So in Lumetri color panel, change the exposure if you want a brighter effect or less. And try to change the color temperature as well to reach different looks. So basically, this is a transition example I created. Make sure to keep the intersection between the two videos right when the light hits most of the screen. Add fade in and fade out if you wish, and that's it. Voila! That's it! Super duper easy! Once you create a library, we'll start using it easily in your projects. If you enjoyed the video, hit the like button, subscribe if you are not yet, and follow me on Instagram. Thank you for watching, this is Oma, and see you in another one.